And if you want to contribute to us financially, we have a Patreon with four different levels. We also have a YouTube channel memberships, which, by the way, is really growing. And I appreciate all you guys have been buying memberships and giving them away to people. That's really helped our membership grow. So again, if you want to become a member, you can become a member of our YouTube, and it contributes to us financially also. So all of the things we're learning now about this, you know, this warrant it's all sort of conjecture until either Ray Tierney comes out and says, this is why we did an additional warrant on Rex Heuermann's home. That we had information, we found some evidence out in Manorville, and that evidence led us back to go to a Supreme Court judge and request an additional search of Rex Heuermann's home to search for this type of evidence. And this was another report a couple of weeks ago from the Manorville search.
Now, new search now underway in the woods in Manorville, Long Island.
CBS 2's Jennifer McLogan is there now live with what we're learning tonight. Jennifer.
Christina Maurice, good evening. Investigators are here in a wooded area of Manorville, a police source telling me it is connected to the Gilgo Beach homicide investigation. The DA in statement said that they are working with NYPD, Suffolk Police, State Police, that, quote, investigative steps continue. Emergency services has been on site with cadaver dogs. We saw nothing unearthed or collected. Canine was searching in wooded areas off Schultz and Wading River Manor roads. Last July, as you recall, Rex Heuermann of Massapequa Park was named the Gilgo Beach serial killer, which he denies. He's been charged in four murders. I was here in Manorville in the year 2000, again in 2003, when partial remains of other sex workers Valerie Mack and Jessica Taylor were discovered. Their body parts were also found near Gilgo. Heuermann has not been charged in those cases. Police were to wrap up their investigation here today at about 6 o'clock. It is unclear if any evidence was found. We're live in Manorville tonight. Jennifer McLogan, CBS 2 News. Maurice and Christine, back to you.
So could it be that they found evidence, or they had information from a confidential informant, that Rex Heuermann was involved in the murders of Jessica Taylor and Valerie Mack? Could that be what led them to seek another search warrant for Rex Heuermann's home? The possibilities. I almost guarantee that the Manorville search is what led to the additional search warrant being applied for Rex Heuermann's home. I can almost guarantee that. There's no way that just out of the blue they came up. But let's not forget, they took out the evidence they took out on the first search warrant where they were there for 13 days. That evidence is probably still being gone through. In other words, they're still searching through that evidence and trying to figure out, well, what does this piece of evidence mean? Where was this taken from? That's why when you collect evidence, it's so important not just to collect it correctly and to package it and invoice it correctly, but to specify where it was recovered from and what potentially it could mean. Because it could be that the case detectives, and that could be, it is, the case detectives don't do all of this evidence collection and the invoicing of all of this evidence. So who's doing it? Well, the crime scene detectives. So if they don't specify and be very specific about what the evidence is, where it was recovered from, what it potentially means, to explain to the person or persons going through this evidence, then you're not doing a very thorough job. And none of this is easy stuff, guys. And when we're talking about biological evidence, DNA evidence, hair fibers. You know, when we talk about the bodies of the Gilgo Four, they were covered in, or wrapped in that burlap. So is there burlap bags in the home of the type that were found on the bodies. That's so important, right? But if you don't, if the investigators that are even collecting the evidence, I'm sure they know that, because before they go to execute a search warrant, there's a, I hope there's a debriefing. They're debriefed on what they're looking for and what specifically happened in these cases, so that they're not left out in the cold. Because, you know, most of the crime scene detectives, they're very scientific minded. They're evidence minded. They're really not, most of them, and I don't want to get killed for this, but most of them aren't street cops. They specifically go into a crime scene because they're of a scientific bent. And thank God they have detectives, sergeants, lieutenants, captains of that ilk to go into a very difficult unit like crime scene, because it takes meticulousness. It takes intelligence. It takes patience. One of the things, I'm not that patient, so I wouldn't be a good crime scene guy. You know, I'm not that meticulous either, in case you haven't noticed, but you need people that are meticulous, intelligent, right? And of like a scientific sort of background, have that sort of brain function. Because when they go into these crime scenes, they have to bring their brain with them to think. You know, you hear use that term, think outside the box. Think of what this piece of evidence means. And then, you know, in this case, the first time they did the search warrant here, they needed like emergency service type cops to go cut open walls, to cut open tubs, to remove plumbing perhaps. So all of this, and when you're doing that, potentially you're also destroying evidence, you know. Whit H from the chat. Yes, it's lots of woods. You can go miles without seeing a house. There's a lot of woods and brush, fallen trees, etc. While turkeys rule the land, a lot of people dump old water heaters there. He's talking about Manorville. Yeah, it's sort of like when you saw on The Sopranos, the New Jersey Pine Barrens. That's pretty much what Manorville is like. Miles and miles and miles of woods. So the perfect place for someone to dump something. Whit H, what happened to his wife being sick? You don't hear about that anymore. Well, you know, there's so much. Cat 47, pretty funny.